Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. Who doesn't love shortcuts? It may not result in your favor if you take shortcuts in your life, but take my word for it. Keyboard shortcuts in Excel are a lifesaver. The day when you won't be needing the mouse to do about 95% of your work in Excel, that's when you can consider yourself to be a budding Excel expert. So let's get you there. I have compiled a list of top keyboard shortcuts and tricks for Excel which I think you should use in your daily work to make it easy and, frankly speaking, a bit fun. So let's begin. I have divided these shortcuts into two parts, basic and advanced. This video handles the basic level shortcuts, which are in four categories: cell contents, cell formatting, formulae, and navigation. But before I forget, I have also prepared a PDF of these shortcuts that you can keep at your workstation. It's free to download and you can find the link in the description and the QR somewhere in this video. So let's take a shortcut here as well and begin. Let's start with keyboard shortcuts in cell contents category. Here I have the sales figures from 2023 and we are going to use this to demonstrate these shortcuts and tricks. From the top, we have to mention date and time of this report. For date, we are going to use Ctrl and semicolon, and for time, we are going with Ctrl, Shift and semicolon. We have some missing entries in row 8. First up, we have the region missing. We know Morocco is in Africa and that we have Africa in here multiple times. To check which values are filled up in a certain column, press Alt and down arrow, and it'll show you a whole list of items in that particular column. Just highlight the item that you need and press Enter. Also, we have our rating missing from the same row. We have these ratings based from a nested if formula. So we want the same formula to be copied and pasted here. Instead, we can simply do Ctrl and D to copy contents from above, whether it's a formula or a value. Just like Ctrl D copies values from top, Ctrl R copies values from the left. Like in this cell here, if I am to press Ctrl R, it will copy and paste the contents from the cell on its left. L3 and show Javier Santos. And no, before you ask, Ctrl L doesn't does it for the cells from the right. It instead creates a table, which is a bit odd since we already have a neat shortcut, Ctrl T, to create tables already. But who am I to question the wisdom of Excel gods, right? While we are in the agents data, check I have the first and last name mentioned in their respective cells. If I have to do the same for all the cells, just press Ctrl E here and it gets you all the first names. And again in N3 to get the last names. This is called flash fill. Coming back to our main table, we want to convert our nested if into values. So we have to copy and paste as values. Let's select the whole row, Ctrl C for copy. And if you have the right click key on your keyboard, which looks something like this, press that. Or you can press Shift and F10 on your keyboard to bring up this menu, which is what you will get if you would have right-click and choose Paste Values from here. To insert a row anywhere, press Ctrl and the plus key from the number pad section of your keyboard, not the one which also has the equal sign. Similarly, to delete a row, press Ctrl and minus symbol, again from the number pad. Last in this part of our video, let's say we have to highlight some clients. So we choose to change the cell color to this. And we have to repeat the same to more cells. Just click on it and press Ctrl Y to repeat the last command. Just remember, this doesn't copy the formula or value from anywhere. This is specifically for the last command used. Let's start with center aligning our headings. And to do that, press Alt H A C. Our sales figures here are just numbers. They should be in currency format instead. So select the whole row and press Ctrl 1 and you get to the format dialog box. Choose currency from here, press OK and done. If you need to hide a row, press Ctrl 9. And this time 9 is to be pressed not from the number pad, but the one which may look like this. Similarly, to hide a column, press Ctrl 0. If you're not happy with just hiding a column and wish to delete it, press Alt H D C and that unlucky column is gone. You know, our agent's data is looking quite boring. Let's add outline borders to the whole thing. Select it whole, press Ctrl, Shift and ampersand. Nah, I think it was better before. No issues. Press Ctrl, Shift and underscore and it's gone. Our sales table doesn't have a total, which doesn't seem right. Let's fix this. Go to this cell and put an automatic total here. Press Alt and the plus and equal to key and we have our total here. Notice the formula, it's the subtotal formula, because my data is in a table. If yours is in a range, it will get you the sum formula. While on the subject of formulas, if you realize the moment you start typing the first letter of the formula, like in this cell, I want to use the formula text join, so I start with T. And Excel shows all these formulas, and as I keep on typing, the list gets smaller. Once you see your desired formula, use the arrow keys to highlight it and press Tab. No need to type the whole formula. I know it's easier to type smaller formulas like sum or even subtotal, but when you are typing forecast.ets.seasonality, this might come in handy. Remember Ctrl D, which copies the contents from the cell above, whether it's a formula or value? If you press Ctrl and apostrophe, it lets you see the formula first, you press Enter and it's done. The last category of this video, navigation shortcuts are the ones that are most heavily used. To move between the sheets, you can use Ctrl Page Up and Page Down. Ctrl and Page Down takes you to the right and Ctrl Page Up takes you left. Incidentally, if you want to select the sheets, you can throw the Shift key in the mix. So you can use Ctrl, Shift and Page Up or Page Down to select the sheets. Similarly, to scroll right or left, you can use Alt and Page Up and Page Down. Again, Alt and Page Down takes you to the right and Page Up takes you to the left. Starting anywhere in your data, if you wish to go to the last filled cell, press Ctrl and arrow keys, depending on which direction you wish to go. Say, if you wish to go to the last cell down, press the down arrow. And if you wish to check the last cell in the same row, press the right arrow key. And you can use this shortcut to select the highlighted row or column as well. You just have to add Shift to the shortcut. So if I am to use Ctrl, Shift and right arrow, it's going to select everything until the last cell from the highlighted cell. And if I am to use the down arrow with Ctrl and Shift, it's going to select this. However, to select the whole column, irrespective of where you are, press Ctrl and Spacebar, and it selects the whole column. To select the row, press Shift and Spacebar, and if you wish to select the whole table, press Ctrl, Shift and Spacebar. However, while within a table, Ctrl and A will do the same trick. Ctrl N will take you to the last cell considering how far your data goes. Not just this table here, but whatever else you have on this sheet. Like if I am to use Ctrl N anywhere, it will take me to cell N104, which is the last row of this table and the last column of our agent's data up top. And again, if you wish to select all this, use Ctrl and N with Shift. Opposite to Ctrl N, Ctrl Home takes you to the cell A1 from anywhere in the sheet. Add Shift to the shortcut and it will select everything from the cell you are into the cell A1. If you wish to have more space for the cells and would like to hide the ribbon up top, use Ctrl and F1 and the ribbon is hidden. To bring it back, press the same shortcut again and it's back. You already know to move right from a cell you can use Tab, and if you wish to go back, you can use Shift and Tab. Have you noticed you have a search field in the latest Excel update? It's here up top. Press Alt and Q and you can search within your data. You can search for a function or command from here. Let's say I want some conditional formatting. Just start typing and when you have conditional formatting come up, use your arrow keys, press Enter and you have all the options right here. Last for today, the Alt F to open the file menu. And you see all these letters on these commands? Just press the corresponding letter and you are there. I should use the save command here by pressing S because we are at the end of this video. And I hope you like this video and have learned a couple of new shortcuts. Don't worry about remembering them, because as I said, I have prepared a free PDF for you to download by using this QR code or the link in the description, which you can keep with you until you are proficient with all these shortcuts. I'll see you in the next one, which has the Excel keyboard shortcut keys for advanced users. If you are one of the advanced users, or even if you wish to be one, don't forget to subscribe. If you think I missed your favorite shortcut, mention that in the comments and I'll add it in my next video. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, share this video with other Excel lovers. Happy spreadsheeting.